Namaste. Thank you for clicking on this video. We will continue our exploration of Jagannath for us of where that is given to the astrological world free by Sri P.V.R. Narasimha Rao ji. I will take his name in every video because the thing that he have done must be appreciated. Right? Let's continue with further settings of Jagannath Hora and what I use. Coming to the next calculation, it is the divisional chart calculation option. Now let me tell you. Over the time, I will use strong words. Over the time, owing to the misunderstanding of people, lack of parampara knowledge, and because of not learning astrology in the traditional way, because of people thinking themselves as over smart and extra intelligent, they have found different methods and procedures to calculate a particular division. For an example, in Hora Kundali D2 chart, there is Cancer and Leo. This itself is a misinterpretation. Why? I'll give you a very simple answer. You read what is written in classics. For an odd sign, 0 degree to 15 degree belongs to Sun Hora, and 15 degree to 30 degree belongs to Moon Hora. For an even sign, 0 to 15 degree belongs to Moon Hora, and 15 to 30 degree belongs to Sun Hora. First sign, third sign, fifth sign, seventh sign, ninth sign, 11th sign. Aries, Gemini, Leo, Libra, Sagittarius, and Aquarius are odd signs, non-divisible by 2. Even signs are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12. Respectively, Taurus, Cancer, Virgo, Scorpio, Capricorn, and Pisces. These are the even signs. Now the point is that everyone, right from Parashar to every sage, they have told that the first Hora belongs to Sun and the second Hora belongs to Moon. They never told that the first Hora belongs to Leo and the second Hora belongs to Cancer. The problem is that Sun is not synonymous of Leo, neither is Moon synonymous of Cancer. Sun and Moon are planets. Cancer and Leo is Rashi. But people don't understand it. People don't understand it because they don't belong to a parampara. This led to the wrong calculation of thing that is now known as divisional charts. There is one more question that I want to ask. That how to find the Hora of a planet is given there, that is okay. But how to find the Hora of a planet, I have just told you. But how to find the Hora of a ascendant, of a sign, is nowhere told. When you don't have the calculation of how to calculate, when you don't have the formula of how to calculate ascendant in a divisional chart, how can you make a divisional chart? Right? My point is partially true. The ascendant calculation part is also partially true. And the first point, that the Hora is of Sun and Moon and not of Leo and Cancer, is also partially true. Because when you go to the calculation of Drekkana, it will be told that the first Drekkana 0 degrees to 10 degrees fall in the same sign. The second Drekkana 15 degree to 20 degree falls in the fifth sign. And the third Drekkana 20 degree to 30 degree falls in the ninth sign from any sign. Now when we talk of signs, we can actually use a Rashi. So in D3, known as Drekkana, you should actually write Rashis. But In Hora chart, in D2, you cannot write Rashis. Not understanding this led to the problem of divisional charts. But however, many people have done researches on it. So I told my point. I told what I have learned in the parampara. I told what I have learned in the tradition. Right? Because tradition at any given point of time will give more importance to the words of sages rather than what people have made up of their own intelligence, because we in parampara believe that the intelligence of the sages, the ideas of the sages, the thoughts of the sages is superior as compared to anything else. However, given an option to choose in the Jagannath Hora software, for D2 chart, I will use Parashar Hora Cancer Leo interpretation. That is closest to reality. Other calculations, use it at your own risk. And a humble request, please don't ask me, sir, how to read Jagannath Hora, how to read Prabhupati Daya Hora, how to read Samsaptak Hora, how to read Manduk Hora, etc. I neither use them nor advocate their use. In Drekana chart, standard Parashar Drekana. In Chaturthamsha chart, standard Parashar D4. In Panchamsa chart, standard Parashara D5. Now you must have been, you must have noticed this particular calculation, Pravritti D5. What is this thing? I will also tell you. So there have been astrologer, Pandit Ramyatna Ojha. He was head of BHU, Banaras Hindu University's Jyotish Department, I think. He wrote a book. I forgot the name. It was Phalit Vichar, Phalit Prakash, something like that. And he threw that book in the river, Ganga. But someone recovered it and published it. In the book, he talked very bad of Varahamihira. He specifically talked very bad of Varahamihira. And he abuses Varahamihira that in D30 chart, there are only 5 Trimshamshas belonging to Saturn, Mars, Venus, Jupiter, and Mercury. If there are only 5 divisions, why it is even called a Trimshamsha? It should be called a Panchamsha, because there are only 5 divisions. It should be known as Panchamsha. There are no 30 divisions, so it should not be known as Trimshamsha, etc., etc. He gives this logic, which I find utterly nonsensical, useless, and arising out of lack of understanding of classics. However, my opinion doesn't matter. But still, my opinion is what I have learned from the Prabhupada. Simple. As simple as that, crystal clear. No surprise that Pandit Ramyatna Ojha threw his book. Because I think at the later point of time, he realized why it was written in this particular way. But someone took it out from the river and published it in a different scenario. So Pandit Ramyatna Ojha started a particular sect of Pravritti divisional charts, where what he does, I will explain it to you. What he does in a Pravritti divisional chart is something that needs to be understood. This is what is Pravritti divisional chart. Yeah. So this is what happens in a Pravritti divisional chart. Suppose I have to make Hora, right? 1, 2 denotes the number of signs. 1 is Aries, 2 is Taurus, etc. So these are the signs, right? Now suppose we are about to calculate Hora. So in one sign, there will be 2 Horas, right? In one sign, there will be 2 Hora. A sign is divided into 2 Horas, right? You know that. We know that. So what he will say, that the first Hora of Aries should start from Aries. And the calculation should proceed in the order of Rashis. So first Hora of Aries will be Aries. Second Hora of Aries will be Taurus. The first Hora of Taurus will be Gemini. The second Hora of Taurus will be Cancer. The first Hora of Gemini will be signed next to Cancer, Leo. The second Hora of Gemini will be Virgo. The first Hora of Cancer will be Libra. The second Hora of Cancer will be Scorpio. The first Hora of Leo should be Sagittarius. The second Hora of Leo should be everyone. The first horror of the Virgo should be Aquarius. The second horror of the Virgo should be Pisces. Now from Libra, the order will repeat. Right? From Libra, the order will repeat. The signs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 will feature again. And now because the complete zodiac came in the calculation twice, he will say that it is named Hora because all the calculation, all the Rashis, all the 12 Rashis feature in it twice. The same thing he will tell you for Drikkhana also. So what he will say, he will tell you that Aries, for Aries, the first Drikkhana will be Aries, second will be Taurus, third will be Gemini. Then it will continue in the same order. Sorry, not 13. Extremely sorry for it. It will once again start from 1, 2, 3. So on and so forth. And in this way, all the signs will be repeated 3 times. All the 12 signs will be repeated 3 times, right? The first repetition, the second repetition, and the third repetition. The same thing will go for D4 as well, right? I'll take some time to explain it. If you don't have patience, you can skip this particular area as well. There's no problem. Right. So what he will do in D4, he will do this 1, 2, 3, 4, then continuing with 5, 6, 7, 8, then continuing with 9, 10, 11, 12. And once again, it will repeat 4 times in the Drikkhana chart because the calculation is so right. So the first thing, the first 12 signs, the second 12 signs, the third time the 12 signs, the fourth time 12 signs, right? This is what is known as pravritti, repetitive. So Aries, the first division for Aries will start from Aries and all the 12 signs will continue in a repetitive order. That is what is meant by the word parivritti. So the parivritti divisional chart is for everyone. So there is parivritti D2, parivritti D3, parivritti D4, right? Parivritti D7, parivritti D9, parivritti D10. And generally 80% of the astrologers from Varanasi, around Varanasi also known as Kasi Banaras, advocate the use of pravritti divisional charts only, which according to them works better. Right? So whenever you see this calculation, pravritti Hora D2, pravritti Drikkhana D3, pravritti Chaturthamsha D4, it is this calculation which is being employed. Of course, I will accept this particular fact that pravritti charts in some cases work well. However, this is not the divisional chart that is told by sages, point one. Secondly, it completely ignores the basic fact that sages have told that there will be a Hora of Sun and Moon, and they never told that there will be a Hora of Leo, Cancer, Aries, or any sign. So coming to me, I follow the calculation strictly. We strictly follow the injunctions of sages. So for us who belongs from the parampara, there is no question of calculating a particular divisional chart. But as I am also a research-oriented astrologer, I have researched in all these different calculations, you know, pravritti calculation and many other calculations, etc. For an example, if you have to calculate D3, Drikkhana, there is a standard method that is given in BPHS and followed in every text, Jatak, Parijat, Jatak, etc. There is a separate method that is given in Krishniyam that is only followed in Prashna. There can be a Pravritti method, etc. as well. So being a research-oriented astrologer, I have researched on all of them. I use all of them, of course. One particular Drikana for one particular thing, one particular Drikana for one other thing. Right? Like the Drikana told in Krishniyam should be used for Prashna and to see sexuality, etc. Right? So I have worked with all of them. But the parampara will be of the opinion to strictly follow the word of the sages. So this is the difference between Pravritti and any normal calculation of divisional chart for the Now, Ashtamamsha. There is no chart such as Ashtamamsha in traditional Vedic astrology. There is no chart as Panchamsha in traditional Vedic astrology. D5, D8, D11 comes into Tajik. Tajik is a branch of astrology, which was practiced by those Hindus who haven't lived in India. So according to my guru, there were two types of Hindus. One who accepted idol worship and remained in India. Another were the Hindus who going by the words of Vedas, rejected idol worship and flee out of India. Lived in countries such as Persia, etc. For a long time, there was no contact between these two sects of Hindus. So both of them developed their astrology separately. After some time, after the discovery of Silk Road and everything, they came in contact with each other and they shared their techniques. So the techniques developed and practiced by those Hindus who lived in Persia, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan areas, the astrology practiced and developed by those Hindus is what is now known as Tajik astrology, Yavan astrology, Hayan astrology. Right? Hayan is particularly yearly prediction branch of those people. Right? So the calculation of D5, D8 and D11 is given in texts such as Tajik Neelakanthi. Right? And in these texts, divisional charts are used in an entirely different way, is used in an entirely different gamut. In an entirely different way. Right? Which 98% of the Vedic astrologers don't know about. And because they are so much prejudiced with what is written in BPHS. They have lost their thinking and research capabilities, is what I find. Right? So, you know, nowadays Vedic astrologers are very much like, you know, they take their own idea that D8 is to be seen for death, so Ashtamamsha should be seen for death, etc. They forget that the calculation of D5, D8, and D11 comes from an altogether different sect of astrology. And if you are going to practice them, practice the complete sect, not only fragments of it. The practice of only a fragment of a sect and not following the complete sect is the prime reason for astrological failure. People don't understand it, neither I want to make them learn. Coming back, so coming to D5, I used to choose nothing. I don't use it, choose nothing or anything. In the case of D8, nothing or anything. In the case of Navamsha, there is a regular Parashari Navamsha, which is told in BPHS, followed in every class. There's a Kalachakra Navamsha, which is derived based on the Nakshatra calculation as done in the Kalachakra Dasha. So that is based on Savya and Apsavya. Krishna Mishra Navamsha is what is told by Sri Krishna Mishra in his Phalaratna Mala. And uniform Krishna Mishra Navamsha was actually a research of P.V.R. Narasimha Rao, which he later came to find was written by the son of Krishna Mishra in his Jaimini text named as Kalabalata. Right? So Krishna Mishra Navamsha and uniform Krishna Mishra Navamsha, both of these used in Jaimini astrology. Kalchakra Navamsha is nothing, just the calculation of Kalchakra Dasha. decoded to make a chart. Regular Parashari Navamsha is the normal Navamsha that you see. Right? Many Gemini astrologers are of the opinion that normal Navamsha itself should be used in Gemini only. Whereas people like Srimati Yangati Rangacharya is of the opinion that Krishna Mishra Navamsha should be used in Gemini. It is a matter of research. I have a course on Gemini astrology, so you can join that as well. Right? Select regular Parashari Navamsha. D11, once again, as I told you. Right? So leave it there. D30, once again, you can use the standard D30 that is given in BPHS, used by everyone. You can use it. You can use a Pravritti Trimshamsha. What is Pravritti chart? I already told you. Sastyamsha like Trimshamsha. It is a particular type of calculations. Sastyamsha calculation. Sastyamsha like Trimshamsha. It is a particular type of calculation. And you will be very amazed to know that I have given so much knowledge free that I think I already have. I taught this particular topic in my first course, Jyotish Prarambh. And as far as I remember, I have made a public video. I have made 2-3 videos public on divisional charts. And there is a video by the name of, I think, Introduction to Divisional Charts. I don't actually remember, right? Like, you know, I teach every day. Since last 3 years, I teach every day. So, you know, I talk about a whole lot of things and I don't remember where I talk about what. But I think I have a video live on YouTube, Introduction to Divisional Charts, on my channel, this channel itself. Search it, watch it, and then you will know what is this Sastyamsha like Trimshamsha. Technically, what is the calculation of a Sastyamsha? The calculation of the Sastyamsha is, like, I will tell you, the D30. Once again, as I told you in the starting, the calculation of D30 is an interpolation. Okay. Parashar said that in an even sign, first 5 degrees belong to Saturn. Parashar, Varamihir, Chatak, Parijat, Vaidyanath, etc. Everyone told that the first 5 degrees in Trimshamsha belongs to Saturn. They never told that the first 5 degree belongs to Capricorn or Aquarius. But people, because they were not from Parampara, assumed that they are talking of either Capricorn or Aquarius. Hence gave birth to D30. Parampara will be completely against it, because there is no mention of Aquarius or Capricorn. But still, what people actually do is they take in an even sign, if it is an even sign, I will remind once again, Aries, Gemini, Leo, Libra, Sagittarius, Aquarius. In even sign, 0 to 5 degree, you put the planet in 0 to 5 degree, which is ruled by Saturn, you put the planet in the even sign of Saturn, Aquarius. This is what people do. This is how they make what they know as Parashari Trimshamsha. What is Pravritti Trimshamsha? I already told you. Right? So he will make 30 divisions of a sign, and for Aries, we'll start it from Aries itself and we'll continue in the order. In Sastyamsha, the calculation is that for any sign, Sastyamsha starts from the first sign itself. So what will happen in the sign of Taurus? The first D60 will be Taurus, and the next D60 will be Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, etc., etc., in the order. And it will keep on repeating 5 times until and unless D60 ends. Sorry, until and unless D60 for Taurus ends. Then for the next sign, Gemini, the first D60 will be Gemini, and it will continue in Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces, Aries, Taurus, etc., etc. We'll continue 5 rounds, and then 12 into 5 is equal to 60. After the completion of 60, Cancer will start. The first D60 in Cancer will be Cancer sign itself, right? So in D60, what happens is, for whichever sign you are calculating the D60, the first D60 belongs to that particular sign itself. For Aries, the first D60 will be Aries. For Taurus, the first D60 will be Taurus. For Gemini, the first D60 will be Gemini, etc. I will show you a slide from one of my courses that I did earlier. So this is what they mean by Trimshamsha, like Trimshamsha. Like you see, for Aries, the D30 starts from Aries and ends at Pisces. Now, if you go by the Pravritti method, because the last D60 of Aries is Pisces, the first D60 of Taurus should be Aries. But the first D60 of Taurus will be Taurus. Right? Skipping the sign Aries in between. The calculation for Taurus, the calculation of D60 for Taurus will end at Aries. So the next sign as per the Pravritti calculation should be Taurus, but because the next sign is Gemini, the next D60 in Gemini will be Gemini itself. This is the D60 like calculation. When the same is applied to D30, it is known as Shashtiamsha like Trimshamsha. What I recommend? I recommend using none. Right? Map each 1 degree in a Rashi to 30 degree in D30 when finding divisional longitudes. So some astrologers are of the opinion that degrees can be calculated in divisional charts. Some astrologers are of the opinion that degrees can be calculated in divisional charts. I am also of this opinion, but it cannot be done always. So there can be two calculations for us. As you know that Navamsha is 3 degree 20 minutes of a sign. So opinion one can be that any planet in any Navamsha will not exceed 3 degree 20 minutes. Another can be that the planet can come from, that the planet can go to any degree in any divisional chart. So we use this particular calculation of that a planet can go to any degree in any divisional chart, and we select map each 1 degree in Rashi to 30 degree in D30. Coming to Ashtotramsha D108, we don't divide the Rashi into 108 parts, but we divide the Navamsha into 12 parts. This is Varga. So this is a concept which is loosely taken from Prashnamarga. What it opines? It opines that suppose D12 indicates a particular thing. The logic is pretty simple. As you make a D9 for the ascendant, you can make a D9 for the D9 as well. You can make a D9 for D10 as well. You can make a D9 for D12 as well. But in this matter, you will have a whole lot of divisional charts. Right? And if you have ultimate number of divisional charts, how much exploration will you give to explain something? But still, owing to this idea, astrologers have developed 3 divisional charts. D9 of D9, taking that Navamsha D9 is the most important divisional chart. Astrologers have made D9 of D9, that is D81. Right? D12 of D9, that is D108. 12 into 9 is equal to 108. And D12 of D12, D12 of D12, that is 144. Right? I think we are pretty clear that it is D9 of D9, D12 of D9, D12 of D9, and D12 of D12. So for this particular reason, D108 is Navamsha divided into 12 parts. Right? D81 will be Navamsha divided into 9 parts. D144 will be Dwadashamsha divided into 12 parts. Simple. There will be no division of D1. There will be divisions of divisional charts only. Coming to Nadiyamsha, when Mr. R. Santhanam translated Chandrakala Nadi, he divided one Rashi into 150 divisions. Like we divided into 9 divisions to make D9, 10 divisions to make D10. He divided it into 150 divisions to make D150. And he made it a uniform division. Uniform divisions by what? what I mean by uniform division. When you calculate a D9, every Navamsha is 3 degree 20 minutes. That is known as uniform. Every Navamsha is 3 degree 20 minutes, 3 degree 20 minutes, 3 degree 20 minutes, 3 degree 20 minutes. But later on, by the efforts of astrologers such as C.G. Rajan and others, we came to know that the calculation of D150 or the calculation of Nadi Amsha is not uniform. So it is not like every Nadi Amsha is of same degree, but Nadi Amshas differ in degree. So to say, taking an example for D9, that every D9 is not 3 degree 20 minute. Say first D9 is 3 degree only. The last D9 is 3 degree only. And the middle D9 is 4 degree. So in a total, they make 10 degrees. But they are not uniform 3 degree 20 minutes, 3 degree 20 minutes, 3 degree 20 minutes. But they are 3 degree, 3 degree and 4 degree. So this is known as non-uniform division. When R. Santhanam translated Chandrakala Nadi, and it is known in the astrological circle, it is a hoax in the astrological circle that R. Santhanam haven't translated Chandrakala Nadi himself. He appointed some Sanskrit knowing pundits to translate the text for him. And he just wrote a commentary and published it with his name. So he skipped it. And by the effort of astrologers such as C.G. Rajan and other people, we come to know that in Nadi Amsha, in D150 that is used in Nadi, the 150 divisions of Rashi is non-uniform. It is not equal division, it is unequal division. For that matter, we choose non-uniform 150 division based on Chandrakala Nadi. Names, there are two names. One name that is given in Dev Keralam, Chandrakala Nadi, as published by R. Santhanam. There is a name that is given by Mr. C.G. Rajan. Mr. C.G. Rajan gave it according to his own research. Whereas there is a name given in Chandrakala Nadi. I go with the names given in Chandrakala Nadi because Chandrakala Nadi is a big text. And there, at some places, you can also find how the Nadi Amshas are interpreted. Whereas I am yet to find the text written by C.G. Rajan. So for this particular method, I use names given in Dev Keralam. Arudha Nadi ruler calculation method, Sanjay Rath's old method, continuous Sanjay Rath's new method taught at Serbia, exact Nadi-like method. Although I wish I use nothing, but still if I have to select one, I will use exact Nadi-like method, not following person, but following sages. Reckon divisional charts longitude from the end of a sign when using reverse reckoning of signs. I don't select it because I never use reverse reckoning of signs. If you use reverse reckoning of signs, you can select it. I don't use it. I haven't clicked it. So this much, I think I have cleared a whole lot of doubts. And the series is going to be long, of course. And as you must have noticed that I am sharing all of my knowledge freely. If you have came to this extent in the video, I'm pretty sure that you know that I'm giving something which other astrologers will listen to the video, will steal the techniques and will start teaching it in their courses, right? So I have open-heartedly shared it to you, to the astrological society, to the world, right? And you know what you should do, right? Thank you for watching the video. We'll continue in the next series of the video. Thank you.